you.
Mike Brown didn't have a gun.
They only met him.
I'm talking about him, though.
You only got these bloody fists. We got a protest about
it. It only matters to the cops. You want to kill one person?
It doesn't matter.
You guys kill yourself all the time. That life don't matter. That life don't matter when you shoot yourself, does it?
We're just here to support the officers.
It don't matter. Shoot yourself.
We're here to support the officers.
We're here to support the officers.
It's due process.
Why did Sarah Colhane not get killed? Why did she get a fucking clean record?
Process.
She kept a cop. She kept a cop in the head.
Do you eat with
Sarah Colhane kicked a cop in the head. She's white. She got a clean record. She didn't get shot. I have a First Amendment right. See, there's this thing called the Constitution. First Amendment. I know the cops and supporters around here hate the Constitution. We know this. Well aware. Well aware. Well aware that you guys hate the Constitution. situation.
What you just said.
Very well aware of that.
You don't respect him damn right. He deserves it. That's exactly what he said.
He was 150 feet away and fleeing. He violated the Constitution.
Due process in America.
Why didn't Sarah Cohen? Does Sarah Cohen deserve to die?
That's not his job.
Did Sarah Cohen deserve to die? She didn't die. She's getting a clean record because she's white. She kicked the cop in the head.
That last bullet to his eye.
If you're white, you can kick a cop in the head and get a clean record.
The last bullet to his eye is the one that made him guilty.
He's
supposed to shoot to apprehend, not to kill.
Fine.
Not to kill.
Why does Sarah Cohen get a clean record? She kept the cop in the head.
I'm not doing nothing wrong.
I'm defending that cop from that woman kicking her in the head.
You're just mad because the truth is being told to them.
You're just mad because you can't handle it.
You can't get through to people who don't support the Constitution, Bob. You just can't. It's just not going to work.
This is America.
You don't even know what you're That's the one that was just telling Bass and you can't handle the truth. She don't bother nobody. No, she doesn't. And she was crying and everything. Then he came up and he tried to apologize to her.
Yeah, or remember when Miss Margaret was driving too slow and they took 9 cop cars to pull her over for driving too slow? You know, I know a white person who drives around with a broken taillight for 6 weeks, didn't get pulled over.
Of course not.
No, we're well aware of the racial profiling.
You don't think that we're not profiled? The large trees are up on the cop cars. They're up on the cop cars. You don't think that we're stopped?
You don't know we're stopped. We know we are.
We are stopped. Try Officer Rastafari.
Can I give a shout out?
We can show you emails.
You're online.
Hey, Kevin, at No Thieves Allowed. We got you, babe.
You're in the cop car. The cops are watching you. Because they watch us.
I don't care.
No Thieves Allowed. I've never stolen. Never done a crime. I've never committed a crime. Never committed a crime. I have every right to protest. Every right to. I was born here just like you.
It's the First Amendment rights. I know. People don't support the Constitution. They don't support the Supreme Court saying you can't shoot. You can't shoot unarmed fleeing people. The Supreme Court said so 30 years ago. You support police brutality. 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 You support shooting, violating Supreme Court orders to not shoot fleeing people.
You hear me? You hear me?
Oh, there you are. We went to Shaw Park. We couldn't find anyone. Now, whose stream is that? That might be one of their streamers. That might be one of their streamers because they've got their own.
Yeah.
Yeah, somebody's copping my style over here. Except for the helmet. I don't have the helmet. But he's copping my vest in my live stream. I'm sorry, Bob. Sorry. Yeah. I'm sure there I don't have a whole lot of viewers because I'm sure no one's watching Bass on the street. Hey, Sonny. No. To kill under the Constitution, and he didn't. The Supreme Court said so 30 years ago. Just because Missouri law is unconstitutional doesn't make it right.
Aaron Wilson, Aaron Holder, Obama tried and they couldn't do it. He must do something.
There's nothing official from the DOJ yet. That's another leaked rumor. Nothing official yet.
That's what you fail to realize. It's about all these racist ass, killing ass cops. Some motherfuckers ain't got no guns, and their hands are hot.
There he is! You motherfuckers!
Yes, too bad you gotta support an asshole that lost, messing with the cops.
Who are you?
He shut his mouth and did what he was told, he would still be alive.
But what is that? It's fine to violate the Constitution and a 30-year-old Supreme Court rule.
You don't see
something
the ground.
Just rubbed up.
Why did Sarah Colhane get to kick a cop in the head and now is getting a clean record because she was white? Oh, she didn't get shot. She kicked a cop in the head. And now she has a clean record.
He's a whole asshole that started this shit.
Darren Wilson stopped him for jaywalking. He didn't know about any of that.
Yes, he did.
No, he didn't. Jim Jackson said he did not know. Even if he did, you cannot shoot an unarmed person to affect an arrest.
So if the cops had, if he had done what the cops had asked,
you don't get to shoot someone just because they disobey if they're not a threat.
And then
no, he did. I'm sorry. Did you see any pictures of any bruises whatsoever? What?
Where were you?
He's live tweeting lies.
What is going on with what everybody else is saying, right?
I'm going on forensic evidence. There was no injury.
You got the forensic evidence.
You just went off of what Darren Wilson said.
Yeah, 16 eyewitnesses said he had his hands up.
16. And when your kids get shot because you guys can kick cops like you did cops.
Sarah Colhane got to kick a cop in the head, didn't get shot, got a clean record.
But what about the two white kids in Warrington that were shooting at the cops?
That were shooting?
That were shooting at the cops and they're alive. What about them? What about them? They should be dead too. Exactly. White privilege. Say no
that's
more.
That's exactly what it is.
Lady, if you pull a gun on somebody, I expect you to get shot.
We support our police! We support our police! We support our police! We support our police! We support
what's the point of coming out to a public protest and trying to hide your face? Are you not proud to support police brutality? Is that why you're trying to hide? No, it doesn't. You're missing the word brutality. You support police brutality. You support police violating the Constitution. Then the cop would not have violated the Constitution, is what you're saying. Cops do not get to violate the Constitution.
Constitution and shoot people 150 feet away when they're not armed.
Blackface over there. That's just amazing. You know, usually they hide behind code words like thug and stuff, but putting on blackface, that's just amazing.
Where?
Over there, that guy in the blue hoodie.
You have to be kidding me.
No, right there with the blue hoodie. We know what blackface is. We've seen it. We know what it is. Really, they just hide behind code words. That guy with the blackface, that's just, wow. He's got blackface on. He's got blackface on. It's racist when you're supporting police who are killing black people. My God. Altering it, putting a line on it doesn't change what it is. Why don't you just put a blue line on your face? You don't have to put the black on. On your face. Blackface at a pro-police brutality rally supporting the killing of black people. Yeah, yeah, it is. In this context, it absolutely is. No kidding, right? If all lives matter, then why are you celebrating Mike Brown's death and justifying it? Seriously. Obviously, they don't to you, or you would be celebrating Mike Brown's death and saying he deserved it. You're a liar. Oh, I'm just trying to see what's going on.
Tell me how. They protest in the black on black crime.
Tell me how.
Our taxes pay the police officers. That's the difference. And I'm 5 times more likely to be killed by another white person. Statistics. Science. Well, now I'm stuck behind the banner. Hold on a second. This is a good song, but I have no idea what it has to do with this, with supporting police brutality. John Hannity and Fox News all supported the Bundy Ranch, and then two of them went and killed two LVPD.
Stop police brutality! Stop police brutality! Stop!
They obviously don't care about the lives of LVPD who are killed by 3 percenters and health keepers and Bundyite supporters.
Stop police brutality!
So we get another song on, sir?
Yeah. engage people about the Bundyites who murdered LVPD, but nobody wants to talk about it. Huh. Wonder why.
We've been teaching our kids for years, and you motherfuckers started killing them. Why do we have to make a procedure for our kids to keep holding their hands up and die?
The First Amendment rights. Yeah, she was asleep.
7-year-old Ayanna Jones.
Ayanna Jones is
12-year-old Tamir Rice. Did they try to take guns?
Hey.
It doesn't discriminate.
When they have guns,
a 12-year-old?
No one pointed it. He didn't point it. That was a drive-by.
You can hear the ignorance coming out of it.
One cop has been punished for killing a black or Latino or anybody else for that matter.
Do you see me smiling?
Very, very rarely.
I ain't got shit to smile about. Do you see me smiling? What's funny?
You don't gotta take it off. You don't want to.
Get away from me. Get away from me.
This started a lot. I mean, it's not like we don't support our
I want the police to obey the law. I want them to do their job and obey the law. I want to be a lawyer. But I can't be a lawyer in a justice system that is not just. I want police to do their jobs. I want prosecutors to do their jobs.
Maybe y'all need to be like me.
He knew how, he knew 40 years ago how racist. Police out here are obeying Justice Department orders to wear their name tags. They don't often do that around us.
Most of the people on this banner are black and Latino.
Or mentally ill. They're black, Latino, and or mentally ill, most likely. 50% of people killed by police are mentally ill. They don't bring the dogs out when there's this many white people. I've only seen dogs four times, and it's only when it's predominantly black people. Oh, there's way too many white people for them to bring dogs out. Oh, well, okay, I think that's a pet dog. I don't think that's an actual police dog over there. Looks like one, but it's not. Brutality!
Use the force!
Police 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 brutality!
Use the force!
Missouri Sunshine.
Shooting somebody that's trying to kill you is a violation of the law?
Not violate. Yeah, well, no, that violates the Constitution because he was not trying to kill him. He was 150 feet away. He told the FBI he was not a threat.
So the FBI made a mistake and the court made a mistake. They were all wrong.
Bob McCullough suborned perjury and gave unconstitutional Missouri law to the grand jury and did not tell them it was unconstitutional.
Bullshit.
Whatever. Believe what you want. It's all on record. Brutality. Brutality. Police brutality. Yeah, there's there's like so many names on. There's like no way I could ever pick up all of those names on my live stream. Clearly,
it is not even.
That's that sign's been around since August. I mean, there's like a ton of names. I mean, there's like over 50 names just from the last 3 weeks at least. There's more than that now.
Exactly. Yeah.
I mean, that just from the beginning of this year.
Police brutality. We support our police.
You support police brutality. Brutality.
Black and Latinos.
And Mentaleo. Mentaleo, black, Latino, yeah, primarily minorities. Minorities. Yeah, I know. All lives matter except for all of these lives. We know.
What about all these lives?
Nobody cares about all of those lives. Yeah, we know.
What about all these lives?
All lives matter.
Including these lives? Because we don't think that's what you mean. We're pretty sure it's not. Do you care about these lives here?
Yes.
Do you?
You know what? I think a lot of them made major mistakes that led to their demise.
Really? What did Timmy or Rice do besides playing with a toy gun? Any white in an open carry state. White people in that state carry real guns around all the time, don't get
and
shot.
You know what? I don't carry it because I think all guns are really good.
So do I. But in an open, and we live in an open carry state too.
A lot of people.
But only black people.
How many people in that list did something illegal before they got shot?
Do you know for a fact that they did? No, you don't.
I don't. I said how many?
And doing something illegal is not a death penalty offense unless you murdered somebody.
It sets them up for it.
It sets them up for cops to violate the Constitution. Yeah, the Constitution said, the Supreme Court said 30 years ago, you can't shoot an unarmed fleeing person 150 feet away. Just can't do it. You can't shoot somebody to effect an arrest. He was 150 feet away and shot while he was running away. He turned around. 16 people said he had his hands up. 16. 16 witnesses. 16.
You guys are fooling us. You've been doing it for so many years. You think it's the normal thing to do. And you just want to kill folks. You just want to kill people. And then you're supporting the killers. We don't paint our police with the same brush. So don't paint us with the same brush. We're decent people. And we want you to.
I want police to not violate the Constitution.
You guys been running the country for
I want cops
years.
To stop violating the Constitution.
I understand that.
My uncle was a cop, a St. Louis City cop.
Okay. He's an exception. Right?
My uncle was white. He recognized the rampant racism in the St. Louis City Police Department 40 years ago. He recognized that all of his other officers, when they saw black people, anything in their hand could look like a gun. My uncle said, if you're in the wrong state of mind, anything could look like a gun. And that's why he saw that in all of his fellow officers.
Not all of them.
St. Louis in particular. They need the cops are
trying. They shouldn't try to hide.
When police are whistleblowers, there are certain police who have tried to whistleblow and they get killed. They get arrested. They get harassed. Fired. All kinds of things. When they try, because this thin blue line protects lawbreakers, people who break the. I want to be a lawyer because I support the law. I want to support police if they would stop violating the Constitution and ignoring the Justice Department's orders. I did go to school for a while. I got too sick. I'm disabled. I got to. No, I don't have to turn it off. I can film you in public. You're in public. You want to show that you support police brutality. You're in public. Yeah, that's what you're doing. You're supporting police brutality. you're supporting police who violate the Constitution. I did, and I will go back. Fine. I want to.
No, they're not.
A kind girly was walking in his apartment stairwell. A kind girly did nothing wrong. He opened a door.
When you're interested in honest civil dialogue, get back to me.
What justified a kind girly's murder? Somebody tell me what justified a kind girly's murder. I'd like to know. These are my friends. I'm with them as much as I can be.
I just didn't know you were here. I just watched you on the history.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Okay.
Hi, Heather.
Hi.
Hello, Heather. I'm Christina. It's nice to be nice to you.
Okay. You haven't seen me on other live streams? You watch live streams, you've seen me on others. No, I'm fine. Except for the ones on this sign, obviously. Including the ones on this sign. Including the ones on this sign. Including the ones on this sign. Department who murdered a guy girly for opening a door. That's amazing. Wow. That's one of the most amazing things I've ever seen outright in a movie. That's just amazing.
Don't even go into the movie. It's just entertainment.
That's just wow.
Great.
I'm just amazed by the blackface. I'm used to them hiding behind the word thug and stuff. I'm not used to them being so outright and wearing blackface like
right.
that.
That's the racism.
I know.
That's the racism in it.
I know. That's just amazing. Brutality. 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 Violating the Constitution. Support the police violating the Constitution. Violating Missouri law. Legal observer, thank you. Appreciate it. Very much appreciate the legal observers. Did they arrest somebody? Who did they arrest? Was that before I got here?
She came up with Elizabeth.
With the curly hair? Jesse? Oh, no.
They came up here
in the
They had a circle up here, they did.
Uh-huh.
They got in the middle. And evidently she touched the cop. The same old thing.
You sure the cop didn't walk backwards into her like they did in New City?
No, I didn't actually.
That's what they did in New City. Oh, don't touch us and then walk backwards.
Right next to her.
Yeah.
And that's exactly what he said. He said, if you touch me, you'll be arrested.
And then he backed up into her on purpose. Yeah, I know. They have tricks.
back up.
I'm sure we have some better music. I know we have better music. Where's the boozy?
Y'all want to say that?
Where's the boozy? Oh, oh, okay. I wanted that one. I see. Conversation here for a second.
Killer cops.
Killer cops. He was shot on my birthday. That's right. But see, that's not very likely to happen unless your son is mentally ill. Because the people who are killed by police tend to be racial minorities and people with mental illness. You know, non-disabled white people very rarely get killed by police. And if they do, police don't get away with it very often. That's really the big issue, is if they kill somebody or whether or not they get away with it. I'm
I don't care if you're green. I don't care if you're pink.
Whatever you have to do to feel better about it.
I'm 5 times more likely to be killed by another white person.
Of course you are.
So, I don't understand this whole black on the ground crime. You're furries.
What is the black culture? Tell me what the black culture is.
Now about 70% of matter, but then they say Mike Brown deserved to die because they don't actually believe that all lives matter. That's just their diversion tactic.
They
think it's a game, they think it's a joke.
I know.
stay in church. Get a new fucking profession.
One who keeps tearing around, one who can.
Tells you what, they always kill our kids.
But it's okay.
They ain't shooting them because they don't want to get shot.
But it's okay for the West to cross shot.
Exactly.
Yeah, like, I know. Oh, you know, but this is your job.
Exactly.
Yeah. So that exactly. Really lets me know who you serve and who you protect.
Oh, we know. We know.
System.
We know.
So I deserve because I was walking. So, like, after
you were standing, we were just standing around visiting.
I deserve to be shot.
I was sitting. But
I mean, they tell me visiting. That the kids deserve to be shot because he was 12 and he was playing with a toy gun in the park. I mean, but it's a toy. If
you
don't,
you know, my
ex. Stop manufacturing them.
Exactly. My ex used to play with those toy guns in parks all the time. Nobody called the police on him, nobody shot him. Yeah, I know. Well, that's a psychological thing among races, among cops and races. They think they see black boys as older and less innocent. They do. It's a psychological studies on.
Because they hyper-masculinize the black culture, black yeah. People in general.
They do it to little children.
More masculine than white people in general. So black men are seen as the epitome of masculinity.
Yeah, where's your wheels? You had wheels the other day. Where's your wheels?
That's the whole point.
You need your wheels, honey. Yeah. Yeah, you need your wheel. You had wheels the other day. That'd be helpful. What is going on over there? That's what I'm trying to say. What is going on over here? There's something going on. Icky. I'm trying to figure out what's going on.
And the lady was like, oh, you know what? They have the same talk as my kids.
No, you didn't. What about the talk you have to have with your kid not to walk into a stairwell like a guy girl in New York? Open the stairwell door. All he did. Open the stairwell door. Yeah, I always thought the stairs were dangerous myself, but for a different reason.
I sent you an invitation. I have a very, 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 very last minute party.
Oh, okay. I saw something about a house party. Houses don't tend to be
You're right. We got some steps up to the house. I don't know how you would, or if you can handle that. Probably not, but that's what you're saying.
There's times where I've done it, but crawling the stairs.
No, I mean, right. I understand.
It's not your fault. It's federal law that, you know, there is no requirement for houses to be accessible.
Right. Yeah.
There should be. It should be federal law. But
well, certainly newly built ones should be. No. Everybody should have to retrofit.
Legally, the only housing required to be accessible are like first floor apartments of post 1991 apartment buildings, and even 90% of them don't. I used to test them. Through a legal aid office for HUD, and 90% of the ones I tested that were built after 1991 were still in violation of
accessibility requirements?
I mean, I don't know how readily it can be done when you were doing an improvement. So in other words, if I were reporting my steps. That's why I was suggesting that.
And lied and said it was a black officer that shot him. That whole story was a lie. Dylan Taylor was racially profiled for being Latino, and then right-wing media leached his pictures and said he was killed by a black cop. That ain't a black cop's arm on that execution video. It's not. It ain't.
And that's the problem that we're arguing about right now. Brutality talking about.
Dylan Taylor was a victim of racial profiling, too. And then he was a victim of right-wing media. What did that mean? Said something about getting the next one. I have no idea what he meant. We have lynchings, it's just not with folks as much anymore.
So you can't tell me that has nothing to do with back in the day, but that's
not even just the way it's our neighborhood, it's our education, it's everything is our job. We lived it.
We lived it.
When you tell us we're not living it.
Why it was unconstitutional.
You know why he was scared? If he was scared, he shouldn't be a police officer. Because the narrative that's around black men, everybody demonized him. The fact that he called him what he called him, it made it seem like he was a scared person.
Huh? When you feel like a 5-year-old.
A 5-year-old when you're 16.
Yeah, but that's not what he told the FBI. He told the FBI that he wasn't a threat.
Racial
the tape that I had, the clear plastic tape for socks, it's got the risk.
Come on, hold on.
I don't know. I'm not even sure if my ride's still here. Yeah, I know. All these unemployed protesters got to go to work.
What they talking about right here?
Institutional racism, I think. It's kind of hard to hear. It's hard to hear out here.
If anything goes wrong, just say.
Well, it's kind of hard because I'm screaming.
Well, I'm saying, like, once it's open,
if it's over, okay.
If you look up the tape,
shots were fired, then he turned around.
With a gun?
Because if you look at black neighborhoods, they're heavily policed. Why would a black person put themselves in harm's way when there's police officers on every corner of Ferguson? Every corner in black neighborhoods, there's police officers. They heavily police us because they're trying to find crimes that aren't there.
A little bit. Stepped out of your media role a little bit there. I saw that. I kept separating myself. That's why I don't have to trespass.
Yeah, I took a
They got lots of name tags today.
Yeah.
Except for one. Okay. Yeah. I'm just saying it, you know, if they come out and mace me and I have to zoom in on my film later, then, there's no name tag. I can't file a complaint. So, just saying. Need to have them visible.
Whose side are you on?
Freedom!
Whose side are you on?
I served in the military. I feel like my job was waiting.
You have the right to remain silent. He did it.
You protested on the sidewalk. They could just come and arrest you. They've done it for you. What do you want to bet?
You're gonna turn your ass
down. I have to
They're gonna decline unlawful assembly. That's
we're gonna be hit by three bags. We're gonna get in trouble.
My cat!
I'm running out of fans! I want
Come see.
Well, I don't want to go down there and find nobody there.
Yeah, 2 miles away from where the protest was.
Oh, okay.
It's dangerous for the power.
Thanks. Oh, what you want to do is
a nation project.
You know what you're
doing. Open invite so far this is small.
Bring your ass.
Come on. What time? What time?
Oh, I got it. We love coming.
What time?
When the motherfuckers get there.
What time? We're gonna get paid.
When them motherfuckers come now,
they wanna come.
They're always fucking up shit, so we're gonna fuck it up.
Tell me what's gonna get the gray-ass people standing. That's a fucking hypocrite. Because all lives matter.
It's a great thing.
No. We out here getting our ass beat and shot up by the police. No motherfuckers pig-assing up and leaving. Jason Patton, two of all lives matter. Really what you bitches want to say is that white lives matter. White motherfuckers are privacy. White motherfuckers
are privacy. Unless it's only PD officers who get killed by Bundyites, then they don't care. I never saw any of them say anything about that.
A lot of your
supporters out here, the same people who supported the people who pulled guns at police at the Bundy Ranch last year. 3%ers and oath keepers. Oh, they're cute. Aw, cute puppies.
Look at that ignorant bitch back there holding
her. I'm like a little slang.
You little bitch! They mad or no?
What is looking? She like the poppy B word.
If you motherfuckers don't take your ass home, you will be subject to arrest. Tear gas and pepper spray. Thank you.
And rubber bullets.
Don't forget the rubber bullets.
Excuse me, officer. You have the only people standing over there right now. We want to know why the fuck are you going to gather over here and not get motherfucking tear gas, not get pepper spray, and every time we come together, this is what the fuck we receive. Tell me that. I'm going to do it.
Throw this away.
Motherfucker, you eat the same food your dog doing. You gonna call me up that way? That's how I bet you are.
Don't say that.
Yeah, don't get those dogs out of here. Those dogs are innocent. those dogs are innocent. Get them out of here.
Thank you.
goddamn brick. Freaking crosswalks. Go across the street. The guy with the dogs got up in one of the girl's faces and touched her, and then it didn't go well from there.
I'm going to stop.
He's going to come up and put hands on people. He really shouldn't bring his dogs.
Maybe another 5 minutes.
The guy with the dogs put his hands on.
Get the fuck off these motherfuckers, cause the next motherfucker swing is
over. There's no problem.
What the police feel about you motherfuckers today, I better whoop your ass.
No, it's Ferguson. He got all up in Miss Margaret's face and called her everything but an N-word.
Exactly.
I was there. And then he tried to come up and kiss her later on. I was there. I seen you there.
Well, what's she talking about? Yes, but I read it there. I have no idea what she's talking about.
I think it was a different guy. I've seen the picture of that guy. I think it was a different guy.
But last one, about 2 weeks ago. Yeah.
But they got each other.
Yes. Okay, I guess I'd better try to get across these bricks. I hate these bricks.
I know that's right, because I got hit with many times.
I got hit with hell.
And I ain't seen no one that's coming up.
I didn't see you running over there. Did you come over there?
No.
No, the fuck you didn't.
I don't see shit.
You did not, though. Fucking down. And
keep the peace between both of us. You kept the peace between
us. Every time I keep my motherfucking signs, you motherfucking maneuver. These cops don't.
But a motherfucking swing of mouth at him, you want to be
cheating. These cops, listen to
me. Clearly, that is a stimulus.
Where is motherfucking motherfucking me? Because you're not telling them to be peace. You did do something. Y'all killing my motherfucking people. Y'all killing my fucking people. And you motherfuckers don't have no respect for us.
Oh, that's
an assault charge. Every fucking day, we gotta come out and do motherfucking stuff.
I got charged with assault of a police officer for holding a purple hand. Now, come on now. That was your department that did that.
It's fucking open season.
Yeah, their spidey senses acted up. I remember that.
It's fucking final destination. Hey, hold up. I wanna fucking know. Is this final destination?
Is
this final destination, bro? I think that's what y'all need to name y'all department because a motherfucker never made a statement.
What are you doing?
Fucking with y'all here never make a statement. You can't bring in this motherfucker.
And you said that you
haven't
done it, but you can talk to the friends. That this is oppressing people. That's why we're out in the street. And the way that you facilitated that whole thing, who was the only protester that got arrested? A black protester who was holding a banner, who had gotten like hit, he had gotten like people thrown at him, and all of that. And she's the one that got arrested by that man right there, who put her in a chokehold. Now, when you guys do stuff like that, that makes it seem like you are doing something to us, i.e., you are shoring up the same system that's oppressing us. So that's where the anger is coming from.
Down,
put it in some context. Why is only one protester arrested? It was an African American woman. Out of all these people that got hit by protesters, got pulled by, you know, the Leo supporters, all of that. But the only person that was arrested was an African American woman protester holding a banner. Why is that? That you can protect them, but not us.
That's always. They did the same shit on the loop last Saturday.
They did do that same shit on the loop last week. They did. I saw that on the live stream. I watched that happen on the live stream. That did happen.
Darn it. I can't believe I missed that. Rewind that and press play.
Rewind it.
And I finally was like, look, you're passing.
Jesus. No reason for there to be bricks in a crosswalk. Ow! 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 I hate bricks. There's no excuse for bricks in a crosswalk.
I want to know who's going to be next.
I need one of those. I need a race traitor shirt is what I need.
Get shot because I'm black. I want to know on my neck because I'm black and my thug. I want to know.
And at the end of the day, it's like, who's committing most of the crimes? It's white men that actually commit more crimes.
I want to know how you label me.
Are you okay? You were going backwards. I was going to grab you.
No, please don't grab me. I'm fine.
Tell me I love my people.
No, don't grab me. I dislocated. It's painful.
You know, I know you're kind of going back and forth. I'm but it's like, they're coming.
While my people land in the middle of the street.
You know what I'm saying?
But not I just want to know.
No, we just said that. We didn't say it. We said the institution.
It's called police.
No, we're against police brutality.
Police brutality.
I have a question.
If we attack the whole institution on this specific issue, we can hopefully get policy in place that'll stop it entirely.
And affect the individual.
We don't have to worry about it versus the bad ones. We don't have to worry about it. We have policy.
And I will argue that all police have to worry about it because the idea of racism, the idea of
all that people might
look at him like, oh, he's not racist. You see, you don't understand how white people perpetuate racial idealization.
No, I am a white person.
But no, I'm saying, since you understand it, you understand why we're going against the larger context of all police. Each individual, they might not be saying all the call him a nigger. You know what I'm saying? They might not say that, but they do perpetuate white ideas.
I never seen
that
attack
the whole institution.
Instead of saying anything to them, this is what they did. Instead of saying anything to them, they said, move back. Get over there.
You know, it's something that Darren Wilson.
Oh, you gotta get down. But you didn't make none of
that. But you didn't make none of that.
Do you think that he
didn't
write that he shot Michael Brown because he
wanted
to lock my
eyes? I just want to say, FBI, fuck the
game. You know, those are
He told the FBI my friend was no threat.
They're linked. They're actually linked if you think about it.
He was 150 feet away.
Wow.
From 150 feet away?
We see countless, all the time where there's even white men who shoot and kill people and they're able to go on trial. Why is it that you try here and kill so many people, but you're able to go on trial? The fact that if he did steal cigarettes or whatever. I don't care if you stole cigarettes all over. That's
not a death penalty offense.
But my thing.
He was 150 feet away when he was shot.
That is true. But the fact that shouldn't constitute.
That's unconstitutional.
You know what I'm saying? Why is it that he has to die? When you look at Wilson, did he have these scratches on his suit?
No.
He didn't. But Mike Brown is laying in the street, dead, in 4.5 hours. And it's surprising to me because they think that black people are always typing up racist.
Kai Gurley opened a stairwell door.
If you don't admit that white people perpetuate ideals about race, then you guys don't.
I have a question.
We get the point of it, so we see more than you guys do. We honestly see that, and it's not easy for white people to check themselves. So they're saying, oh no, that's okay. You can continue to think that. Continue to be, lock your doors when a white person, when a black person walks by. You know, like when a black man walks by, it's good to grab your child. You know, because he's a criminal. You know, they perpetuate those ideals in the media, in the news, just talking to your friends. You know,
It's unconstitutional to shoot someone who is not armed, who's 150 feet away, who is not a threat to you. But you told the FBI it's not a threat. Every person. I still have a question. I have a very important question. It's okay, go ahead.
There's a Florida State football player. I'm pretty sure. He lived, I think, in Tennessee. I want to say, like, him and his girlfriend after he graduated. He got into a car accident one night, like, in this white area, and, like, messed up his phone or whatever. So he couldn't find any, like, he couldn't call for help. So he got out of his car, like, walking in the same room, knocking on houses or whatever, trying to get help. No one answered. Finally, he knocked on this one house with, like, a white woman inside. And she opened the door without looking through the hole. She got, like, with her at the time, or her husband gets closer. She didn't open it, saw him or whatever, and just freaked out, closed the door, and, like, locked it, dropped it off, whatever. So he's, like, hurt and banging on the door, like, asking her for help. And she calls the cops, like, oh, my God. Like, this black man just came in my door. He's trying to give me, like, my child. And, like, they come up, and, like, I think it's two or or three cops. They come up. He like runs to them or whatever to try to tell them what's wrong, and one of them just shoots. No questions asked or any history. And it's like, number one, what made that black man?
Ain't that right, sir? Right. You say you swore them.
This woman bolted her door and called the cops, and this black man was shot. What made the white officer so afraid? He just shot him with no question. And then the fact that the guy got off, that's why we're angry. Because in that case, a guy, he was a football player. He was really smart. He had a job. He had a fiance. He was going to get married. So he had his whole life ahead of him. And even in that one, he did no crime. He still got shot. And we still didn't get justice. That's why we don't think there's any justice. Because how can that happen? And he did everything right. And he still died. And the guy still got off. That's why we're
so angry. And you understand how many crimes people steal things constantly? And they don't die for it?
Sarah Colhane kicked a cop in the head and she gets a clean record and didn't get shot.
Okay. Is that what you were saying?
That was part of it. But I also, I'm curious about, you know, this, you know, pro-brutality support. I'm curious where it was last June, because I when Las Vegas police were shot by Bundy Ranch supporters, Bundy Ranch protesters who were pointing guns at the BLM back in April. Back in June, they went to Las Vegas and killed two officers. I posted about it on my Facebook because I supported those officers' lives because I support all lives. But the same people, my same, you know, Facebook friends who support Darren Wilson, none of them ever said anything about the LVPD because it was there, because it was, they'd supported the Bundy Ranch. And so Bundy Ranch people went and killed police officers, and the same people who support Darren Wilson were awfully quiet about that. Why didn't anyone who supports Darren Wilson be supporting LVPD back on Facebook back last June? That's what I want to know. Because it wasn't on Fox News, because Sean Hannity went out of his way to support really the Bundy Ranch. This is a really intelligent...
I don't know.
You want to jump in here and us trying to come together and understand, then you are welcome to.
I'm just I'm just trying to figure out why people who claim to support police didn't support LVPD when they were killed by white people.
I don't know. I guess we're just
I'm just curious, you know, I supported police on my Facebook. I don't call them pigs, yet I'm called anti-police.
You know, we're out
so,
here.
You know, I want them to follow the law. That's what I want. They keep breaking the Constitution and state law, and I have a problem with that.
And I disavow any police action that is designed illegally and
fundamentally racially
charged.
They need to change the system.
And white people need to be
able to fight for
the
same.
They need the training. They need to be on the job.
Yeah.
Paying attention.
I know. I know.
A majority of like the police officers in Ferguson.
I know. They don't care about police who are killed by right wing.
And they don't live in Ferguson. They come from other counties and cities around them.
No, I supported those officers. I posted it on my Facebook for several days. No, me neither. My late uncle was a St. Louis City police officer. There's no, you know, and he recognized the racism in St. Louis City police over 40 years ago. He was like, he recognized among a lot of his fellow white officers, you know, he said, if you're in the wrong state of mind, anything can look like a gun.
You
know, my uncle didn't even want to carry a gun.
Like a criminal light, and they don't see
that. Even black officers do that too. They perpetuate racial stereotypes, and they arrest black men.
There's actually scientific studies that show that it's institutional, and even black officers do it too.
The notion of group thing, you know, the fact that you're now wearing a badge, we're different than that person in the street, right? Mm-hmm. All of a sudden.
What time, George?
You can actually put me in that. I don't trust police officers.
You don't have to.
He didn't use the.
Do you know where that lies, though?
because if you, there's a lot of anger pent up because we
love. You have the First Amendment right to disrespect.
So you have to wonder.
That's just a fact.
Somebody like me, it's
not
having the right to protest, having the right to assemble. Of course, there's emotions for you, but nobody's breaking anything. Nobody's breaking the law.
They were nowhere near us. We were yelling in their faces.
They were on the way. They're all the way down the street, and they came with the tanks and just threw tear gas at us. You know what I'm saying? So it's like the fact that people are disrespectful, calling the police every single word. And look, I understand that because why would you respect somebody?
I never even cursed at them until they threw tear gas canisters directly at my wheelchair.
Yep. Until I got maced.
I never said that till they threw tear gas canisters directly at my wheel. It did not curse at them until that point. And even after the first tear gassing, I was just kind of stunned. I'm going, there's a ton of tear gas down there. Then they advanced up the street, gassed us again. That's when my cursing started.
You understand how you think that maybe all nothing to do.
So the fact that when I said we're out here protesting institutions, the institution of the police.
I never cursed them until they violated my First Amendment rights and shot tear gas canisters in my wheel.
I don't suspect them either. That means they don't touch me. That's what I'm saying.
But
I'm not trying
to. The fact that he is even an officer in the first place.
I'll cuss them when I see them breaking the law.
The fact that he's pulling over constant black people. You know, the fact that it's been But most of them do, because they have a focus on this, and that's how they're trained too. And the fact that we have the mass incarceration of black and Latino men in jail, when most people who create crime, that doesn't make any sense. What do you mean?
I mean,
most of the black people. And Latino people who are in jail, well, men who are in jail,
the media has the power to change the direction of where things are going. You all really do. You all have a lot of power.
When white people commit drug offenses, than black people. You know what I'm saying? That doesn't make any sense.
People believe what they see on TV.
Media
done brainwashed the mess out of people.
What I find out, because I'm probably one of the newest people out here, is that majority of the people out here, which I knew it wasn't true, but hardworking, college educated people. But on the news, we're welfare thugs and all this stuff. It's amazing. I'm like, I told somebody, I'm sorry. I've had some of the most intelligent conversations in this group of people than I've ever had in my life, and deep people. And then you'll never know it because the media won't show you that.
The media twists it.
That's what politicians use to get elected. They use black faces. You don't never see them showing white people lined up at the welfare office. They're not welfare more than once. You don't never see when they're lining them up when they're showing the criminals and that. You don't never see them showing the guy who killed the kids at Sandy Hook, the guy who shot up all those people in Aurora. They show a black face, and that's what white people see.
And that's exactly the point that I was trying to make to some people earlier, is that they desensitize the worth of a black man on TV. And I asked her, where do you get your ideas and your thoughts of the black men? From the media. And she said that's what they show. They pick what they show.
She got mad because I showed this picture.
If you look at the idea of laws, laws have to be.
Yeah. And any black person that does something is a criminal in this.
He was like an extremely smart man, but he was still troubled.
Troubled.
He was which guy
is that?
That's the one that shot up the people in the movie theater.
And whenever white people commit crimes, they're troubled. Something happened. Yeah, it's something that
they can kick a cop in the head and get a clean record, like Sarah Cohen.
Exactly. It's the problem right there, and then people don't know how to become unbrainwashed from that or unsee it after they've seen so much of it. And it's just, it's crazy.
if you look at something like
because like, it's how the press perceives what the press and politicians.
Yes.
You know, it was Ronald Reagan that used that black man's face to say he was going to control crime.
Our country is based on looting. Our country is founded on looting. Are you kidding me?
I mean, nobody said anything about, you know, all those white people setting 89 fires in Ohio. Nobody, they were revelers. Nobody called them leaders or violent or even rioters.
They would look so good to go around.
You know, that's how all those women got off by Bundy. Because he was so handsome.
Yes.
He wasn't.
So, are you going anywhere from here?
I think it's almost
over. It's over.
I don't know that there's anything planned today. I'm hearing something maybe tomorrow, but I'm not sure.
Look,
they have film of those police officers lighting that one door.
Here she is, chocolate! But then what? I found her.
Oh my God, I was in front of her.
And then there was her
right by my car. I couldn't go to my car.
And I did, and even, but he did.
He did.
He killed somebody, right?
He
violated the Constitution, too.
But didn't you just say, though, that somebody shouldn't, you know, commit a crime no matter what? And if it's in protection, wouldn't that cause as that? Wouldn't that cause the same thing?
I don't like to him.
But you just said no matter what.
I don't believe that.
He was 150 feet away. It was unconstitutional. Just because Missouri law said he could do it doesn't mean the Supreme Court said he couldn't 30 years ago.
It's a failure to understand the law, apparently. To commit a crime, but he told the FBI he did not feel threatened.
Out of
protection, right? You feel like you, if somebody was coming at you with a gun or whatever the case may be, you were protected, right? No matter at all costs, right? But then doesn't that fall in line with the fact that you're still committing a crime? You're taking their life away?
He committed a crime by not filing an incident report.
I'm not saying
if somebody attacks you and then they run 150 feet away, no, you can't shoot them 150 feet away.
Yeah, that might be true sometimes.
We're actually having a conversation.
The ladies are talking. He's not getting a word in edgewise. No, he said that himself.
Y'all know me, bitch. Y'all know me, they just want y'all to listen. Okay, thank you. I don't know what we're saying.
No, I'm just saying, you know, take it away from the whole Darren Wilson, Michael Brown thing. You know, all I'm saying is when the looting, not even just looting,
yeah, because they released their dogs on us.
Wait, and then with that, you said all you saw was the looting. Right. Did you see anything between from when the looting first, the first week, and then before the announcement came out? Because we were here protesting for months, but the cameras went away and they weren't seeing that.
Peaceful protesting.
We were peacefully protesting August 10th when they attacked us with dogs, and then the looting started an hour and a half later, two blocks up the street.
After the police came and started coming with dogs, starting to antagonize the peaceful protesters.
They were threatening.
I was there on August 10th. I was there August 10th. We were attacked with dogs before anything happened.
How would you feel, though, if someone killed your child despite the circumstances?
The business owners did not kill anyone.
No, listen,
I know, but I'm saying if someone regardless of the, because I feel like mothers, regardless of the circumstances, would be angry. If someone killed their child and the system that you're supposed to put faith in says that person can get off free, how could you just be like, oh, okay, well, you know, okay. The system did its thing, that it worked. You're not gonna feel some type of way and be like, angry. Your child died and you can't get this so-called idea of justice. Your child died for something silly, for some cigarillos. Like, they put a price on your child's life. Would you not, like, as a mother, would you not be angry that your child's life got taken?
I wouldn't destroy it.
But in effect, you can't,
this is what you
want
to talk about, white life. You want to, this is what's gonna happen to Ferguson. And it's sad. And I have actually been on my knees over Ferguson just because of this fact. What's gonna happen is all taxpayers, not just white ones, but all taxpayers, all people who own houses there are gonna start moving out.
You're right,
and
I've heard
people say that. And this is what's gonna happen. All people, taxpaying people are gonna fly from there. They're gonna get out because it's not safe. You know, they have something that other people don't have.
I didn't say that.
I said they're gonna say that. They're gonna say, I can't shop here because I'm gonna get robbed. I can't walk down my street.
I don't believe that because most of the residents there are black in the first place. So it didn't get bad until the police came. You know what I'm saying? It didn't get bad. It's already heavily policed, but once Mike Brown was shot and killed, the police antagonized the situation when there was already peaceful protesting going on. The police started this, if you want to be completely honest. The fact that they militarized the police on people who live here, like civilians. You militarize the police on civilians. People who live in America, you militarize the
people who are threatening.
They're not threatening anything. They did that before people started looting.
They attacked us with dogs long before any looting.
All that tear gas is like illegal.
Yeah, it's illegal.
You can't use tear gas on non-rioting people, and we weren't rioting.
There are people who are in the military saying that they didn't even use that kind of stuff when they went overseas, and they were using here. And those police most of them did not have the training for that stuff. Yes. Like, why were they so afraid? Black people, they're afraid. Society is telling America to be afraid of black people. That's a problem.
I've been in protest my entire life.
Why were they telling black men white women be afraid because black men are gonna come rape you and stuff like that? Like, it goes into history. We never gave y'all a reason. We never gave white people to be a reason to be afraid of us.
You know what? If you had lived in the 80s, you would see that it wasn't like that.
No, it was. Oh. Maybe, my mom
yeah,
was
yeah, it was. Honestly, I lived in the 80s.
And you may have had choices to live in your.
Somebody's like confused.
I
lived in an integrated town. Like, still saw crap like that.
Well, you and a white woman experience something different.
They still
than me
pull over people for driving while black.
You're saying our experience isn't true.
You're just trying to. No, you kind of did though. Could you just say if you lived in the 80s?
Okay. I mean, honestly,
what you see is what we live in. There's a difference between
seeing and wait, and then with your, you believe in God. You may have felt him, but you haven't seen him with your eyes. But you still have faith.
Right?
Like, it's the same, not the same thing, but do you understand what I'm trying to go with?
Like, you've never felt we've been through, but you can try it.
Or you've never seen it with your eyes, but you're saying.
In the same respect, you can see from my side and what we see, you know, and the things that we see. And media does a lot, you know. Yeah. I would agree, you know, that, that, you know, because we didn't see any peaceful protesting going on.
No, that was all those pictures that were on Twitter and live streams, and the media didn't pick that up.
Hi, Clark.
How the hell you find us?
Yeah,
were you,
he was coming over here, I was like, what is this dude doing? Anyway, but what, but, you know, you have to understand our side, too, like, what we see is going on.
Okay, well, then can I say, because y'all have so much power in American society.
I have no power. I have no power except to go exactly like you. You know what, let me tell you what happened in my home. The homeless shelter got closed down.
They're gonna do what?
And it was really, really sad. And
so
this whole, you're so passive aggressive.
So a group of people band together and decided to show up at the mayor's inaugural. You know, the mayor was the one that shut it down. We decided to show up. We were peaceful. We had the signs. It didn't come to that because, you know, because the mayor kind of saw things our way. But it wasn't white people, it wasn't black people, it wasn't, I say protesting because we've heard that word so many times, but it wasn't angry protesting, it was, this is what we want, you know, and
Ferguson didn't get angry till they stick the dogs on us.
With that though,
really didn't. I was there August 10th.
But
yeah, we were there August 10th. Nobody got angry till the dogs got released.
We only have so much power to vote, but the people who have money, and honestly, people do listen to white people more than they listen to anyone else. So if y'all were to go with the media, and we could go and help together, we could collaborate together and go and say, stop only showing us these terrible like stories about minorities. Show some good stuff too, because honestly, I think our society in general is too negative. And we need to see more of the positive stuff in the news, not just minorities, but everyone, and do stuff like that. Oh, like, make sure the education, I don't know where you live, I would love, because I keep telling people this, people want to focus on the wrong issues of the people getting angry and stuff. I'm like, then focus on what you can do. Tell your state or whatever to spend more money in education in places that don't get it, because we work in an elementary school that has no resources. They don't get anything. Like, the food is terrible. Like, they had to work. Like, there was a couple of times where their heat got shut off, and it's the, like, this, you know, like, it's cold in, like, St. Louis or whatever, and they were, they've been struggling. But if I try to tell a white person in this area to listen to that, they won't, they'd be like, oh, well, black people, you know, black on black crime, or this, or they're gonna grow up to be criminals anyway. So it's like, put all this stuff, there's so many things you can do. If you don't want to focus on certain issues, there's things that white people could do that could help all of us, and then you wouldn't have to worry about, like you said, something way earlier, about us, like, we don't want to be equal, we want to be more, but that's not true. Like, I think you're seeing us that we're equal, and maybe society has warped everything to make it, you see, or not make you, but make, warp your eyesight to make it seem that we're equal, but we are not equal, we're not far from equal.
And we're probably never
all we
going
want
to be.
Is to be equal, but we're not there yet. And all society has done is warp that and make it seem like we've made progress and we actually haven't. It just manages, like you said earlier, keep sweeping things under the rug and make it seem like we're making progress. But you really haven't made that much progress.
Right. But the police aren't going to make that progress. I mean, what are they supposed to do? Stop policing?
No, that's just one, one part. That's
stop
only
violating
one part
the
of the problem. The problem is that they're killing us. They're killing us. They're enforcing these tactics that are racially charged and fueled. You know what I'm saying? So the fact, like, I keep bringing up the prison system, because if you look at the prison system, who is in jail most of the time?
Opened a
and
door
who makes
in
money
a
from stairwell?
Who makes money from it? The people who make money from it.
But who can change that? Can the police change that?
The police.
I mean, if you do a crime, if you
well,
don't
that's
do a crime,
true
if you
too.
Do a crime, I'm gonna arrest you.
But it's different when I'm constantly in an area that has predominantly black.
It is what it is.
Yeah.
Really
yeah.
It
is
the predominantly black, right?
That's why I'm saying 65% black. But the fact that they heavily police that area, and you look at Chesterfield, which is way bigger, and the fact that there's not that many police there. Of course, they're gonna
have much more people. You know,
there's crimes happening. This is the thing. Most crime isn't even reported. If you really want to talk about like statistics, most crime isn't even reported. The crime that we talk about is the only stuff that's reported. And if you're in black neighborhoods, only arresting people on warrants and certain charges, you're gonna report that because there's more police there to catch certain crimes. If there's not a lot of police in white neighborhoods, they're not gonna report that because there's not that many police. police there to actually
there's
catch
a lot of drugs. There's a lot of drugs in my neighborhood, hardly any cops. Wow. She does. She really hates talking to other white people, doesn't she? Wow. Okay. Okay. I see.
I don't hate talking to white people. I don't really like being on camera all the time.
Well, you're in public.
I know. I don't
you're in
care,
public at a
I
protest.
Hide. I can hide.
You're in public at a protest. You're in public at a protest. If you're ashamed of your of standing up for what you believe in, you know. I can't help if she's ashamed of what she believes in, so.
I know.
You're in public at a protest. I don't want to be filmed, wear a mask.
It's taken higher, it's not going to change anything. All you're doing is making the police think worse. All you're doing is making the police, you know, I mean, almost hate seeing the police come up to support them. And protest city come up.
He never shot
it. It's not like the strike. It's yelling.
So, sorry.
He didn't die from getting shot.
Well, he died because he didn't have a lung.
But do you see?
Yeah.
Do you see, even, yeah. Even if you look at that instance with the white older gentleman and he fell to the black woman, if you look at who started that incident?
Plus the bullet.
It was the white gentleman because he called her out her name. You know what I'm saying? And I'm not saying that, like, oh, yeah, all white people are evil, but you guys sit here, if I'm angry and I'm so passionate, you understand, like, why people are actually angry and yelling? Because we're so passionate about this, because it happens
my
so often that
and our voices are never heard. Like, there's a chance that the Brown case would have never retried Georgia had there not been people out there making it hurt.
Yeah, out there protesting.
Well,
you know what I'm
the police militarization kind of helped that
yeah,
along
that's
too.
That's true.
That's true.
That
certainly brought it to national attention.
Getting the word out, and the
they
fact
hadn't
that
you know started attacking people illegally with tear gas. Wouldn't have made international news.
And protesting is not the only thing we need to be doing. I agree with that. That's one.
Okay.
What?
Just the angry
person. That's not all that's happening. That's what I keep trying to tell you.
No,
Most protesting, if you actually think about it, it's fueled by some type of emotion, right? And that's what I'm trying to get you to understand. You have to literally think about why are they angry in the first place? Why are they angry?
Tell me your name again. I met you a zillion times. You're done.
No, I don't talk about it much, but he did. it sucks. But that's something that. No.
The older I get.
It wasn't walking down the street. They racially profiled him and thought he committed a crime.
For some people, for sure.
Kai Gurley opened a stairwell door.
This is my thing. And even,
that's
and
all
he
did.
Even if he did commit a crime, does that constitute his life? Why does the police officer have to kill him if he was like my brother? Does he have to die? That doesn't make any sense. An eye for an eye?
I think she wants to be shot.
I think he shot him because he was afraid of black men. The narrative and the discourse that's around black men is that they're criminals. And the fact that they were and look, it was. No, because if my thing is this, the fact that they, and honestly, I think people were saying like, oh, he's like, Nazi told him to get off the street. The relationship between black people and cops, it doesn't go like this. Not all the time, but a lot of the time, especially black males, and this is me, because I am black, you know, I'm pretty sure he was not like, yes, get off the street, and my girl was like, no, F you, blah, blah. I'm pretty sure it was something like, hey, get the F off the street, and my girl was like, what did you say? And it started like,
we just have to
it escalated because why is it, because when you look at most police officers, it, or just police departments, a lot of them are white. And the fact that he's asserting this white privilege dominance over this area that's predominantly black and telling him to get off the street, like boy, get off the street, like basically that is very similar to like some slave talk. You know what I'm saying? Boy, get off the street. Like saying, get the F off the street, do as I say. And people are like, oh, he's a police officer. You know, we should look. We look. Look.
You know, I used to.
But no, I'm just saying, that's.
But that type of phrase coming from a white male to a
black male is different. That's different. That is different. Because of the
white
history.
Power and a gun and your weapon.
That's a certain authority that is threatening and that's.
And the power. And it's always been that way. And it's gotten worse in my life.
Why should we have to do that? Do you know how if we report that, we have to report it to who? Report it to the police who still perpetuate those same ideals? That's not going to get done. You know what I'm saying? You know there's different countless times where people try to, especially police, who have seen the racial and prejudice that has been perpetuated by their departments and try to speak out and they got themselves killed. Because there would be like a raid, like a drug raid, and they let him. Actually, my mom's friend was a black police officer. He had a friend a couple years ago who was trying to speak out against their department. They were racially profiling black men. And one time they were at like a drug raid or something. And when news got caught of like him trying to speak out against the department, it was like people shooting back at them, and they all left him. They didn't have his back, and he died. He died because he's trying to speak out against the department. So for us to report and be like, oh yeah, this cop did X, Y, and Z, they're not going to do anything because a lot of people don't know. If you look at Darryl Wilson, for example, he used to be in Jennings. He used to be in Jennings Police Department, and he was fired because he was racially profiled.
Yeah, pretty
much. The whole department got fired for doing that.
But they just moved him to Ferguson. They just hopped them to Ferguson. We can do that all we want, but this is still going to happen. It's still going to keep happening. Which is why, you know, going back to our discussion between, like, it's very different if a black man and a white cop, the white cop is telling you to get the F off the street. You know what I'm saying?
You know what? If a black man told me to get the F off the street, I would get the F off the street because I'm not going to mess with things like white
women. Yeah, it's very different.
You continue to get ordered by the police to do something, you become resistant to it.
You say, okay, then, you know, for the white person that has to listen to, you know, like a black person yell at me, I mean, why wouldn't I get ordered? I mean, if you say, you know, Darryl Wilson has had countless run-ins with black people that, you know, constantly just disregard what he's telling them to do, you know, wouldn't you get tired of it?
Doesn't give you an excuse to violate the Constitution.
Right, and, you know, like, why wouldn't you be a little bit more stern? Like, do it right now.
Basically, we need to understand that you're
still doesn't give them the right to violate the Constitution.
I'm white, you're white. You're going to empathize at first with whoever looks the most like you, and you're gonna like try to see that side out first.
Well, I see police officer side, so it's not a racial thing.
See, that's where you're just wrong, though. Racism, as somebody who studies race relations, everything has a racial undertone. You can never say something between interactions that's not racial because it's a false statement. Everything has racial undertones. You can't not be acting in some way according to race. It's impossible. If you're raised in America, I was raised racist. I'm sure you were raised racist. Is that like something to get offended at? No, it's something to accept. And then how do I move forward? Because you have to understand you are raised in a racist society. So go from like the understanding that I am racist. How do I get better? I'm racist. How do I get better? I learn more. Yeah, so do you agree with that? You don't think?
No, I'm just saying, this is where the college was. And the cop said, get the F.
I mean, now we're talking power dynamics of
power dynamic because,
and that doesn't usually happen. I don't know that I've ever actually seen that happen.
That's where you're bringing race in.
No, because it's essential.
We can never bring race into something. You can never play a race card. The race card has been played.
This is what I'm saying. If a black cop told his white to get off the street, he's affecting the fact that he has a badge and a gun. Where it's different when a white cop is sitting here and telling a black man to get off the street or whatever, because this person is saying, this person who is white, who has authority, he sees in all and a gun.
You know,
because most all white men have authority.
That's
they're at the top of the totem pole systematically.
That would be for a lack of your understanding, because you do have authority, and you need to find that agency, right now, because you are white, and that is a kind of authority.
That is a kind of authority.
It is, absolutely.
You have a privilege.
It's an implicit one. It's one that you can't... See, this is the problem with racism. Racism is no longer like, oh, I hate you, like, I hate you because you're black, but there's undertones. And so we can't just ignore undertones and say, just because I can't point it out and say, here, you're racist because you said the N-word. That doesn't mean that racism doesn't exist. That doesn't mean that we're colorblind. It's
tell me what authority I have over
and I'm telling you that I can't point it out right there because
no
racism has evolved.
You're confusing implicit and explicit authority. Like, yes, you might not be like, oh, yeah. You do this, and that's going to happen. But systematically, you have a privilege. You have an authority. You're given. You have more resources.
You listen to more often.
Yes.
You're raised in a much, like, your job opportunities are exponentially larger than any black woman because simple fact that you're white.
Yes, absolutely. That is so true.
Your marriage options.
Your marriage options, like everything.
Please hear me out.
No,
yes.
That's just,
like I said earlier,
you are the standard of beauty because you are a white woman with straight hair.
And blue eyes.
You know the top interracial couple is actually a black man and a white woman. Even black men to a certain extent fetishize this image of beauty as being white. White women are at the top. They are the epitome of femininity.
That's a sort of authority, see?
That's an authority.
Now,
it is.
Just because you're not claiming the authority, it doesn't mean you don't have it.
Who has built the foundation of the idea of race? It goes all the way back to colonization. Europeans, of beauty, all these are just the aftermath of slavery, the aftermath of colonization. Well, we're not.
My family was so poor, we didn't have slaves. We don't understand why we have to always go back to slavery.
We're not.
You know what I'm saying?
Right. Because we've never been slaves. Parents were never slaves.
Oh, okay. Okay, don't do that. But listen, you need to understand the fact that slavery set the foundation for all the systemic racial issues that we have now. White people don't like to talk about slavery because it makes them look at themselves differently.
Why does it make me look at myself differently?
Because you hate the fact that But listen, you know what though, and that's true.
You can own up and try to make it better
because this,
we did.
But no, you didn't. What are you doing right now? What are you doing?
I'm talking to you and I'm allowing you to speak to me, right?
She's
allowing. She's holding court. Whoa, that is some what? Wow, that's some white privilege. Wow.
So
that's the progress we've made, that we can have a conversation?
The progress is that she's allowed because she allowed it.
I'm not allowing you to speak because white people are like, did you? I know you were getting tear gassed on that bridge. Economic system
was based on slavery, selling and buying. Even though slavery, you don't know.
It was not
maybe your parents didn't.
That time.
Your parents, parents came here and took land. Right? Are we there? They took land. It wasn't theirs.
He's Cherokee too.
Okay, well, the nurse. Okay. I took just the nurse. So you got Cherokee and you too?
A lot of us have Cherokee in us.
My great grandma is Cherokee, like straight up.
My great grandfather was Cherokee. I still look like Snow White. I still have a ton of privilege.
Emancipation Proclamation, whenever that was.
Didn't even affect Missouri.
Didn't
affect Missouri.
But meanwhile, you have all these white people who have all this land that they didn't pay for. Land is money. Land is rights. Property is rights. Same thing. Now you release, somehow, all these slaves become free. They don't have any land, any money, any opportunity to make money back to sharecropping, back to slavery. There, you, whether or not maybe you were born poor, that was maybe through the financial miscalculations of your parents' parents. Because white people were given so much land and so much economic ability to advance. We have 20 times on average the net worth of an average black family. So even though you might be poor, you still have these economic opportunities to advance. You can advance so easily up this social ladder in the same way that we have black people scratching and clawing and fighting just to get raising a minimum wage from $7.35. I mean,
but that's not just for black people.
Okay, so, it's not.
I mean,
but
come on, that's all people. I know, that's not just for
anytime
black
you
people.
Say
all people.
But there's a different dynamic there when you're looking at you throwing the element of race. There's a totally different dynamic.
The amount that happens probably to black families is less than how much that happens to white families. So then
that,
it's just
I don't understand how that
I'm saying that there's so much black people, black families that are probably depending on that minimum wage versus the white families that are depending on that minimum wage or like more wealth as they go up. There's probably more white families who are making more money than the black families that are probably working the minimum wage. If that makes sense. I probably made it really complicated.
So more opportunity for growth upwards of the minimum
wage. Whereas black people was not. You know, you can have a black person who is scrapping and a white person who is scrapping.
Yes,
but the fact that they are white, and I'm not just saying like, oh yeah, you know, they're white. Like, this is actually a race. This is true. They will have, their economic mobility is higher because of that.
Can I ask you what your name is? Karen. Your name is Kira. If you both submitted job applications, Karen, Kira, you would get called back, even if your resume is the exact same. So you're changing things that don't need to be changed. Let's say you're the same age.
Even if she was the same age.
Same, let's say you're the same at everything. Karen gets a call back and Kira doesn't. But Karen is a white name.
Karen is a white name.
It is.
Karen is a white name.
So there's a study, right? That was done by the Harvard Business School. They took two resumes the exact same. One was like Emily and the other was like Lakeisha. Same exact resume. Everything was the same. And they sent it in. Whose resume got called back?
Oh, yeah.
Emily. And like it's statistically proven. That's a study.
Even when you get phone interviews, the tone of your voice, you have your voice, you sound like a white person. I sound like a white person. They do not. Interviewers can tell that, and they call back white people more times than not when everything's the exact same.
And you don't think that they call back intelligent people or people who
just talk. Well,
who defined the term properly? But I'm saying, who remember talking about things being created, like the beauty standard being created, and even the terms of black and white being created. The term civilization or being civil and not being uncivilized, those are defined by white people. So whatever y'all thought was uncivilized was wrong, so y'all put what y'all thought was civilized in place. But that doesn't mean it's necessarily
mean
true.
It's true.
He started it, but she got charged. That's how it always happens.
The ACT and the SAT are culturally defined.
And if you've seen the way...
Honestly, okay, can I say something?
If you're my secretary, you know, or maybe I'm hiring your secretary. and you're going to be, you know, maybe typing up my business proposal, or, you know, something like that. I mean, I don't want an unintelligent person.
But can I
want someone who can speak proper English.
Well, can I say something like that?
Are you saying that they're not speaking proper English? Is that what you're saying? Because that's what it sounds like.
This is what I'm going to say. People, actually, there's been a study done on, do you know what Ebonics is? Ebonics, so like, you know, or like slang, like black slang. It is, if not even more complicated than the English language, as far as pronoun usage, all that kind of stuff, grammatically structured, it is actually more complicated than the English language, right? So, but this is what I'm saying, though. I'm getting back to why is it that people uphold the English language and be like, oh, you have to speak proper English, when it's actually, Ebonics is just, if not more, complex and complicated. There's no correlation between, the known language was spoken by Native American people. That's the known language here, if we're being honest. Because of colonization, because Europeans came here and they dominated.
Accent on the same language has nothing, no correlation with intelligence, right? Like, if I say you all and someone else says y'all, that says nothing about our intelligence.
It doesn't.
No, that's like that's a regional dialect.
It's a culturally
different. So that's like saying.
And you're saying you're treating proper English with intelligence. And so. You're only able to accept proper English as the way you speak it, which is the way white people speak English, which is not the way everybody speaks English. They're talking to you.
We know how to code switching.
You totally don't know that.
We're trying to explain. So black people, for example, there's this thing called code switching, right? So we have to switch our code, our dynamics, the way we talk, even the way we dress. When we talk to white people, we have to in order
because
to be accepted.
Otherwise,
because
you'll be called ignorant or uncivilized.
Listen, if I came up here and was like, yo, what's up? This is what we're going to talk about, blah, 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 talking a different way. Like you just said, if you heard that on the phone, you're not going to hire that person. Why? Why is it when I'm the same person?
But that doesn't display her intelligence.
Exactly. I'm the same person who...
Because if you're going to be writing, anything for me,
that's writing, no, that's not talking.
That doesn't mean she's gonna write like that. It's like, oh, hey, how about this? It's a beautiful.
Good homie, you trying to cut a deal?
The fact that you just called it proper.
The problem is that the standard is business runs on white people's terms.
Yep.
So the problem is that the standard language is white dialect, it's the white accent. And now we're caught up.
We're caught in
like a really nuanced portion of this
white
argument.
Who come from England?
Come from England.
What about Southern accent? What about white Southern accents?
She looked at her calendar too.
You were talking to her earlier, so yeah. I was like, how'd you get in this? Come on, Shauna, start talking. But you know, all I'm saying is, I mean, if I moved to Germany, I would need to speak German, right? Properly. If I spoke the broken German that I know, they wouldn't hire me. And not because I'm not intelligent, but because maybe I don't sound intelligent.
Why do we all have to speak English and why does that have to be the epitome of intelligence? Why do I have to speak English in order to get a job? You know what I'm saying? Why is English, and you have to even break it down even more, why is it the fact that English is the dominant language and has to go back to colonization? The fact that if white people never took us from Africa and brought us over here, or if they never came over here and destroyed Native Americans, it would look very different. And there would be a different type of language that was here, and that would have been at the top. So for you to say like, oh, if I call in a job interview and I was like, yeah, my name is, you know, Maya Johnson, and talking using a bunch of slang and saying like, oh, she's obviously dumb. You know what I'm saying? She doesn't know what she's talking about. She's obviously unintelligent. But when I'm talking to you like this and using my proper voice and using, you know, the large words that I learned at my in this white institution of education, you know what I'm saying? When I'm talking to you like this, that's when people notice me. That's when people can listen to Maya Johnson. Maya Imani Johnson.
We speak slang, but we know to use proper English, you know, with job interview or in the job place, you know, like we know.
Okay. I gotta go. Are you guys gonna be okay?
They're fine. They're not gonna be.
I need food.
Oh yeah, I'm sure they can. I know they can. That's not the question.
You like me on camera.
Yeah. Okay.
Is that why you come up?
Not fighting.
Okay.
No fight here.
No.
I just have questions. Fight. No fight. Never fought.
Yeah. Anyway, it was nice talking to you. I'm sorry that we couldn't come to agreement.
Yes, I've carried
the knife at night.
Maybe.
I miss that.
Because he's more.
Because he's more aware than you.
He's enlightened.
That's why.
But no, he's not aware because he's able to empathize and understand where we're coming from, at least trying to, and then know that he will never be in our shoes. And the fact that he's even them trying to talk to you, he understands his privilege. They understand their privilege. The fact that they were sitting here and trying to talk to you, you just totally
because they're not. You know, you all and I are. Totally different conversation than what they were.
But they were actually spending some, they were saying some real knowledge and saying some real points that we agreed with. So don't discredit that, because they're the ones who are actually helping us and helping us more than us just talking. They're on our side. You know what I'm saying? They're the ones actually doing work. The white people that are doing work. Yes, we're having this conversation. This is beautiful and I'm glad that we're having it. But the fact that they are here making these points and actually on our side, they're taking such a large step from the white majority that you're still a part of, that, you know, they're doing so much. They're doing so much to combat racism.
Because they're forcing themselves to see the things that you said you haven't, things that they may not have seen with their own eyes that they recognize are true in American society. And hopefully, I'm hoping one day, because you seem really nice, that maybe you can come to that.
The whole thing, like, this is where I come, you know, as far as, if this was, are you okay?
You know, someone just said they see me on channel today, but
anyway, I don't know, I guess I have a hard time understanding the whole racial part of.
And so who's,
let me finish.
Well, you didn't let me finish, but I'll let you finish.
I'm gonna let you finish.
You know, like why there's a racial line drawn on being against police officers. And that's where it's not the whole force.
You know, we can continue to go back into this, but it's like the line has already existed. Nobody drew it. You know, and that's what I'm saying.
How did the black officers?
There's a lot of inner conflict.
Yeah, there is a lot of inner conflict.
I feel like you may be looking
at it
on
an
individual basis,
yeah, black,
which
black
I praise you and I wish
union.
You could all do that, but
yeah.
There's so many problems
I know.
In the overall
it's
institution.
Ridiculous. It
we
is.
We aren't able to
it is.
Yet.
It's
Hopefully
ridiculous. It's one of the most bizarre things.
That actually happened, I doubt it will. Like, that we could just look at each other like that, but the problem is, it's not like that. There is stuff, there's problems with the overall society, so we can't look at the individual yet until we fix those big problems, and then we can look at that. I think that you aren't necessarily seeing a lot of those things. I hope maybe this will be a seed planted, and maybe you just
don't let it discourage you.
Yeah.
I'm like, it's so much for a day and a couple of hours.
Or not to find discouraging is because of the long term. You've got to have
to. Nobody's saying that we should have.
I want them to obey the law. That's what I want.
But even, and actually, it gets really more complex, because there's also this notion that, you know, why would we even have the law put in, this notion of the law enforcement that we have now, when it has been fundamentally rooted in racism? We need to dismantle that. There's that aspect.
It needs an overhaul.
Patty rollers.
But you know, that's another discussion. But what I'm saying is, what I will hope for you to do is, when you get home, because, you know, books, whatever, research the institutionalized racism and just learn about that. And just read for yourself. Because I can spit this all day and, you know, tell you as much as I know.
And you know, I can talk all day about
I
my
ask
side.
A question.
Yeah.
I am curious. What do you think Jesus looked like? I'm just very curious.
I would say olive skinned and hair probably about like yours.
think that he's white.
Okay.
And blonde hair.
Okay, thank you.
Adam and Eve on
the other. I was just curious.
You know, Adam and Eve said that that possibly the Garden of Eden was in the upper part of Africa. You know, I don't have a problem with color. I honestly don't, you know. I don't think baby Jesus was this little blue-eyed blonde hair, you know?
Yeah. I thought he was dark, and if he was a Jew, I mean, I figured he had darker skin. I just wanted to know if you knew that.
Megan Kelly doesn't seem to know that, so we're just checking.
If you don't do it for yourselves, like you both said, you have children of color.
That's a
relative of color, like, do it for them. Like, just research. Like, try to understand. Like, you'll never truly be able to understand, like, everything that was said today because you're white. But just trying to empathize is so important.
And maybe you guys could do the same for white people. You know, like, try to understand where we... We're not all against you. And just like all,
all
of you.
Not all men, not all cops. Yeah, we already know that diversion tactic.
It's not that we assume that. It's just the fact that you use that word. You have to think about why did I use that word in the first place.
I don't even understand, like, why you got it. I just meant, like, you know, like...
But you have to... But the fact that you don't understand just shows that there's a different dynamic going on.
Why would you automatically assume that I meant that I was allowing you to speak to
that white people? Because that's what... That's how I've lived life.
That's
how I've lived life.
By constantly working, we are people of color. You know what I'm saying? We are black females. We are black.
A lot of people say that they're...
And the fact that people... even put color right in front of my sex, my gender, you know what I'm saying? That's the first thing that they look at. And, you know, people say, why we bring them to talk about slavery? It's because you need, like, people, I think what white people need to understand is that it's fundamental to understanding any idea of why black people are angry, why black people are sitting here and thinking the fact that you said allow, you know, why do you think I'm mad about that? You know, it's not because I'm sitting here like, oh, you're an evil person. I think you're an evil person. I don't think that. But I know the word you use and why you use that is something larger than that. It's not just
true, but
it's something in your subconscious.
You know that I wasn't saying it.
But you did say it.
The majority of
did you understand where I was coming?
I understand. I immediately know. That's where I want
you guys to like, and maybe take a breath before you automatically just got it.
But you need to understand what we have been oppressed for years, and literally people sitting here and saying, you're worthless, you're black, this is what black means, blah, blah, blah. You can't assume that we can just be like, oh, yeah, I know exactly what you meant. It's not actually to combat racism. It takes you guys. It's not our problem.
We caused it.
Y'all caused it.
We caused it.
It's not our fight. Yeah. And you're perpetuating it.
No.
It's not.
I'm sorry. I apologize for white people. I do. I'm sorry.
Not be oppressed. Because we didn't create it. It takes white people to do that. You guys created that in the first place.
We did it.
You
don't think that black people have a part in continuing it on?
And what do you mean as far as what racial like?
Yeah, just racial things as far as like say that
anyone
would
like,
see a nightclub is predominantly black. I wouldn't be welcome to it.
Why not?
That's a different dynamic.
No, I go to a black nightclub.
That's a different dynamic because race, the idea of race is not charged by just like, oh yeah, I don't like white people. That's not racist. But no, I wouldn't automatically.
There's a difference between institutional racism and personal racial prejudice.
There's a difference between personal prejudice and institutionalized racism. And the fact that, you know, there's a notion that black people can't be racist. And honestly, I totally believe that because the idea of racism has
that.
To do with power. It has to do with institutions. Who is at the top? Who has? Who
you just did
who
that.
Makes up most of the population? Who holds most of the wealth? It's white people. So who has less of it? It's black people. So the idea of race and like racism right now, like we talk about, it's institutionalized. You might not see black people being lynched. You might not see, you know, segregation as far as like there's still segregation, but as far as I'm saying black people, you have to sit here, and white people, you have to sit here. It might not take on that form, but it still exists. And I will argue it's way more dangerous because the fact that we have to even have this conversation, I have to convince you that it even exists in the first place.
No,
that's dangerous.
I've never said that it doesn't exist. I'm just saying that I think that
that a lot of times black people, just like what happened to my boy, you automatically assume the worst about me, that I know, or you, whatever. I allow you to speak to me.
I don't think it's because you're white. I think it's because of the sign you're holding. I don't think it's because you're white. I'm pretty sure it's because of the sign you're holding.
Personal basis, and like these problems, they're not microscopic and individual problems. It's bigger than just you, and that's why they thought that they weren't seeing you as an individual, as Karen with red hair. They were seeing white people, right. And that's the problem. Is that this system is so big, we can't see anybody as individuals in this system. That's what it is.
That stereotyping, yeah. Which is exactly what's going on.
Yes.
Which is exactly what the white people are doing. You know,
I don't get stereotyping. I'm pretty sure it has more to do with the signs you saw.
Predominantly, we see black people acting bad, and we see black people murdering people.
But that's
and
a different.
We assume
that's
I better get away from
that's
them.
A different,
y'all might kill
that's
me
a different type of stereotype, though, because right, the stereotype that affects. But listen, no. But no, listen. No, I didn't. Honestly, I didn't say the worst.
That's not the worst. That's not the worst.
But listen, though. The stereotype, when you have white people stereotyping black people, is completely different. Because if you look at it and say, oh, this person is a criminal, oh, this person is yada yada, all this person, if you're looking at this black person, it's like, oh, this person is a criminal, this person, that is affecting so much more. And have that be the popular narrative, like the popular story, like all across the United States, you are literally creating this idea of black people that white people are totally afraid of. When white people are the majority, that's crazy. That causes a total shift in mindset on how white people view black people. But the fact that I just simply, you know, I thought that you were being racist just right now, that's not going to hurt you as far as economically. That's not going to hurt you institutionally. That's not going to cause a huge rift in the whole white society and cause you to be oppressed. That's not going to do anything except for make you be like, oh, man, I didn't mean that. You know, feel a little uncomfortable, but that's it. That's absolutely it. And honestly, I will argue the stereotypes that we have about white people are only result of the stereotypes they had about us.
That's why black people can't be racist.
That's why black people can't be
they
racist.
They only respond to racism.
We respond to racism. We didn't create race. I didn't know I was black. Somebody has to tell me I was black. The notion of the fact that you're black, you're white, you're Latino, the fact that those categories were created, they weren't created by me. I didn't call myself black. White people called me black. White people established that category, the Negro. You know what I'm saying? But you know why though? But there was a standard, and the standard was white. And anything that was not white was bad.
So the category benefited white people over time.
It changed because there was a time where Irish people and was it Italian?
Italians.
They weren't considered white, but then they started noticing that minorities, like the population of minorities, are getting bigger and could rival the white people. So they started changing what the idea of white was because they were afraid.
More people.
That's why they killed Sokolov.
You know what I'm saying? And now you have this distinct view, distinct line drawn between our black. Asian, Latino, Latina, and then white. And the fact that white now encompasses Italians, Irish, Scottish, all that kind of, ethnicity.
It didn't until they came
that creates a large gap for a certain particular type of people that we can never be a part of.
They tried
we'll
to immigration.
I don't want to be white. I would never be white. I would never be accepted as a white woman because I'm not that. You know what I'm saying? I'm seen as the exact opposite of white. And the fact that you even call me black shows that I'm totally opposing whatever you are. The fact that white is opposite of black. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? The fact that what's even created.
I it's a hard thing, and I'm like, I feel like this may be in like the first time you've heard so much of this in just a couple of hours. So I understand
really,
if you're not.
Believe me, I hear it a lot.
We
live in a very diverse, like I said, we live in a very diverse place, maybe because it's out there with us already. You know, like it's out there and we don't have the same problems that you have here in
Seattle. Yes,
you
do. Yes, you
do.
Yes, you do.
As far as being segregated and such, we don't have the means.
It just may be different.
Yeah, I didn't realize there were any in Colombia until
I
left. I grew up in Colombia. Yeah, I didn't realize how segregated it was until I left.
Diverse doesn't necessarily mean like on my neighbor's black.
I didn't realize how like actually racially segregated Columbia was till I left. The police there aren't as racist as they are in this part of the state. They're more classist there, but they still are racist. I've seen them pull over people for driving while black.
But no, because there's a different.
Yes, you have.
That's one thing.
Because I believe in law enforcement.
Do you believe in them killing people?
You believe in them tear gassing people for their First Amendment?
Oh, okay. It's the thing about, I think, that police, that authority, you know, should be respected. When that authority begins to act, overstep their bounds, then we go higher and we do something about it. Just like I was talking about with the mayor.
That's what we're trying to get done. That's what we're trying to get done.
It's always culturally and racially classified. So you have more respect.
They
attacked us with dogs.
That's not the worst thing in the world to yell at police.
A Hispanic man was shot and killed two weeks ago for yelling at the police. Look it up.
A Kai Gurley got shot for opening the stairwell door.
Not just men, but also people of color, children have been shot by police.
Ayanna Jones was asleep in her crib when she was shot by police.
It's not even the fact that, you know, we're sitting here, you know, yelling at, you know, police officers. There's anger behind that because this keeps happening. This literally keeps happening that police officers are using that authority that you just mentioned earlier and taking it upon themselves to kill people based on racially charged, you know, stereotypes like you just mentioned. You know what I'm saying? So that's why there's no reason, you know, I can't even, you know, I guess for me it's different because, you know, you try to put your perspective. But honestly, if I was a white person and I saw that a lot of like white cops are shooting black children, I would be offended because you know, do you understand how that perpetuates the stigma about white people in general? I would literally be like, my race is not like that. You know what I'm saying? And come with the black people and be like, yes.
Yep.
I don't want that to happen again. Because if you say that you're not racist and you don't have these feelings, wouldn't you fight harder to combat that? Because all I'm seeing here is constant people of color being killed by police. That's happening as we speak. That's happening all the time.
Two nights ago, another black person got shot by the police.
And the fact that a child can, and people can say a child should have had a gun.
Like, they plant guns.
They planted a gun on Von Derrick Myers. No DNA on that gun.
I know. You kind of lost me.
I saw it.
You saw the look in my face. Yes. I'm just, you know, like we could go on.
They don't use dash cams. We have no reason to trust them.
And perhaps for police.
That too. But
no, it's a bad tree.
It's a bad tree. At least
it's not a bad apple.
It's a poison tree. The tree is poison.
Because do you know what happened in New York? The police protested those killings and they stopped working. What happened to crime? Can you tell me? Crime went down. Arrests went down.
For hours.
With less police.
How do you know that crime went down?
their stats.
Statistics.
Statistics. They're constant.
Math. Math.
People were happier.
Math and science.
All police stopped working. Not all police stopped working.
Oh, okay. That's
so there was a segment of police who disagreed so heavily that they refused to go to work. Those other policemen reported back there was a drop in crime and a drop in arrest.
Do you think that
even half of
the police
stop
running
for ways to get the next year?
I
don't think we should do
it. No, I don't think it would either.
Because people, there's also a notion of self-policing. Yeah, like, if you look at, when we were even out in Ferguson, for example, and this is after the police were literally standing like right at us, and there was like people, you know, trying to fight. Who policed them? Other people. You know what I'm saying?
Other protesters were
taking charge, conducting traffic, doing whatever we can. We took it upon ourselves. You gotta understand, there was a point in time where police didn't exist. There was. So it's not like all hell broke loose and
Hope
you do your research.
And I posted.
Bye.
Okay. Now I'm killing the stream because it's at three hours now. So I'm killing this because it's not going to save. So bye.